Mayor Faulkner, we had Senate Minority Leader Scott Wilk on our show last week on Inside California Politics. He gave you another glowing endorsement, pretty much said you're going to run for governor. So let's just get it out of the way right now. Are you running for governor?
That's a decision I'm going to be making in the coming weeks, Nikki. And look, I feel very passionately about the direction of our state. Senator Wilk is a great fighter and champion for making change. And so, look, I've been approached by Californians all across the political spectrum who really want positive change in California, and they're really upset about the direction our state is going. So I'm going to be weighing all of those factors. And again, that's a decision that I'm going to be making in the coming weeks.
Can you make it just right now here on the show?
Well, you'll be one of the first to know. But again, I think what you're getting at is the uneasiness that so many Californians who love our state are upset about the direction, and particularly on some of the biggest issues that we are seeing front and center, top of mind, the rising homelessness and, of course, crime that is skyrocketing in California. And those are issues that it's not Republican and Democrat. It cuts across the entire spectrum of California.
All right, so let's talk about two of those issues that you just mentioned right there, because a new poll came out this week from Berkeley Institute, and also the LA Times, Berkeley IGS, LA Times partnered to do this poll, and it talked about some of the issues that are top of mind among voters, 9,000 voters surveyed. And the governor's marks were not good on two specific items that I want to talk about here, homelessness that you mentioned and crime. And these are some of the issues that you ran on in the recall, and let's just be honest, you didn't do very well. The governor did very, very well just 5 months ago, but it seems things have shifted as we speak right now.
Well, they are, and as you and I talked about, the recall turned into a circus, literally, and wasn't focused on, I think, the issues that Californians care most about. And I will tell you, you don't need a poll to see that things are going in the wrong direction. You know, we had a governor that was promising a California comeback, and what we're seeing is a California backtrack. We're falling farther behind. And when families don't feel safe to go to their car, when we're seeing an explosion of homelessness in cities across California, yes, I feel very passionately about these two issues because they were some of the biggest ones that I addressed while mayor of San Diego. You know, I did not defund the police in San Diego. I actually increased the budget by 7%, and we were one of the safest big cities in America. And I also feel very strongly about what we did on homelessness. Again, the only big city in California while I was mayor where we reduced homelessness. I did not allow tents on the sidewalk my last several years as mayor of San Diego. Why? Because we care about folks. We care about folks enough not to let them die on our sidewalks, and that's what's happening when you allow these tent encampments to proliferate. And so, look, we need to change what's going on, and why you see the governor getting the marks that he's getting is because Californians, whether you're Democrat, Independent, or Republican, want to change.
Okay, so let's start with homelessness and crime, the two issues that we're talking about here, because people want specifics now. They don't want to hear, you know, we have to do something and we have to do it in a compassionate way. What specifically would a Governor Faulkner do on homelessness?
I do exactly what I did as mayor. I would set up a series of shelter networks. And by the way, the state needs to take the lead. The governor won't talk about that. He wants to blame cities. We need a statewide approach. And I will take the lead on a shelter network just like I did, but also take the lead on enforcing an obligation to use it. And again, when we made a huge difference in San Diego, when people saw tent encampments going away, because it's not right, it should not be allowed to put up a tent in front of somebody's house or in front of somebody's place of business. It's unclean, it's unsafe, and it's unsanitary. I took a pretty strong position on that, and it worked. And that was one of the reasons why in San Diego, again, we reduced homelessness by double digits. And yet what we have seen, Nikki, is homelessness explode by double digits in virtually every other city. If you do not intervene, I repeat, if you do not intervene, you're not gonna make a difference. And you can throw all the money at the world at this problem, but if you don't have the political will to actually get involved and make a difference, it's not going to change.
All right, let's talk crime. What would a Governor Faulkner specifically do to reduce crime?
Well, first and foremost, I would tackle head on what Governor Newsom refuses to do, which is saying what a ridiculous situation this state has gotten into because he has supported and enabled mayors that defunded their police, because he has supported terrible legislation like Prop 47 that has taken what was once a felony down to a misdemeanor, doing heroin and methamphetamine on our streets, the ability to walk into a store and steal $950 worth of merchandise. And we're seeing what's happening. We're seeing retail outlets literally go out of business. We're seeing our cities turn into something that none of us really recognized before that was passed. So again, you need to talk straight to Californians. You can't get up and just virtue signal. You have to get up and saying, we're going to actually make a change in this legislation and laws that are taking our state backward. I feel very strongly about that. If you do not have a safe state, we don't have anything.
All right, so you're obviously very passionate about these issues, but let's just be honest. The governor has $25 million in campaign funds. He, despite these recent poll numbers, he has been a popular governor. You know, when you announce, the first thing that folks in his campaign and his supporters are going to do, they're going to tweet a picture of you and President Trump. They did it all throughout the recall. And every Republican I've asked this question, they said, well, you know, the governor mentions Trump and so do other Democrats because they don't want to talk about the record. That's great, but it works. That's all you have to do in California is tie a Republican to President Trump and you're done. So what would be your counter argument? How are you going to combat something like that?
Yeah, I don't believe that is going to be effective. And, you know, and Donald Trump's not on the ballot. Gavin Newsom is. And the failures that you and I are talking about on homelessness is because of what Gavin Newsom has failed on. About crime is because of what Gavin Newsom has done. And again, I think what we're seeing, and particularly with these numbers that just came out this week, is that you have people in all parts of our state, again, of all political parties, who are saying it's going in the wrong direction. And we want a governor to come in and actually make a difference on the sidewalk with 10 encampments. We want a governor who's going to stand up and say, I'm going to do the right thing when it comes to policing and public safety. And I think they don't care if you have an R or a D next to your name. They want to know that you're actually going to stand up and make a difference. That's what I did as mayor of San Diego. And that's what I believe the Californians want statewide.
Former San Diego Mayor Kevin Faulkner, hope to talk to you in a couple of weeks when you make that announcement.
Looking forward to it. Thank you, Nikki.
Thank you.